to speak in favor of this request, please come forward. Give us your name and your address, please.
Hi, Larry Sanders, WSA Engineering. I'm the engineer on this project. I live at 5316, also Trail Lake Park. Appreciate all your time to speak. Mr. Martin, some things up pretty well. I'm a little bit curious about the definition of hardship, and maybe the difference is he didn't, with all due respect, he didn't try to design this project. So, your comment, Ms. Powell, about the mobility, our biggest concern is that this building right here, the civil engineer doesn't design the building. That's the kind of size of the shape of the building. That's controlled and mandated by the architect. And it's our job to fit it on our side. All three of these buildings have to be completely accessible to ADA standards, which means they've got to be connected, not exceed like 2% or 5% slope. So, virtually all three of these buildings have to be, because of the shape of this lot, long and narrow, these buildings had to be laid in this order. This line that's indicated right here is 100-foot undisturbed web buffer that limits the usable area right here to just what you see. So what we're trying to do is get as much flexibility in both the number and the size to get more parking central to this building. Right now, these two buildings are very accessible. You don't have elderly people traversing all the way across the site to get their home. And we appreciate any help you can get. But, I mean, to me, that's a hardship. These buildings have to be connected. I have no control over that. And I have to design with this building. There's no other configuration. These three buildings will fit on this lot. So I have to design with that constraint. The hardship thing always confuses me. To me, it's a hardship, but I understand people have different takes on that. But this is simply an attempt to more properly lay out the site and get as much parking as we can around this building. And the parking that we have shown that's being removed by request from Mr. Martin, we are leaving that as accessible grass parking, so if there's a need for overflow parking, or if in the future, even though history pretty much shows that we're correct at 1.5, and that's the BCA standard code by 1.5, that's sufficient for this type of housing. But we're leaving all these areas to be used. We're set the curb down so you don't have a back on the curb. We're leaving all these areas to be used as overflow, or if we're cruising around, to be filled as part of the future. But that's my only, the only area that I disagree is, to me, this is a hardship. I'm not the one who gets to say that, but my question to you and anybody else, if this is not a hardship by the definition, how far does the parking have to get away from this building before you